Hello, YouTube family, and the Maverick in the space again with the best and most credible opinion, fear and fearless analysis. I know me I go around on the debate. Big debate in the United States. Election will come up in November. I know it's in the whole world tune in to lock in for watch a debate. But you know what's the Maverick miss the debate live though. Yeah, me have something though. I mean never catch the entire debate. Me catch a little snippet of it, but me never watch the entirety of the debate. But me go peep around on CNN now to see the post-debate analysis for hear what I must say about the debate. But me watch that for about 15 minutes and me realize that me now gonna get no objective analysis from there, so you know. Because them start playing some snippets and Donald Trump gaff them when they matter about some people that eat dog and puss in Ohio. That's all they me talk about tonight. I said, no man. In a 2 hour Donald Trump said nothing. But some people up at Ohio eat dog and puss. And they know when them go around a Kamala Harris partner. All them I don't know, I tell you how wonderful she was and she wiped the floor with him and it was a one-sided debate and she crushed Donald Trump. I said, Papa Jesus. Maverick need to watch this debate before me form my opinion. Remember me opinion, boss, you know. Them people are politicians and them have them political biases and them emotions entangling all of them opinion. I mean, it's the best and most credible. So, me eventually watch the debate. We get up this morning early and go up on YouTube and watch the entire debate. All right. First and foremost, Donald Trump, I'm a madman, not clean clothes. And me don't think it good for the world for that man become the president of the United States and effectively the leader of the free world again. Him do him thing the first time and win, push back the establishment and come with him unorthodox method and him win and him serve a term in the White House. Me rate him for that, you know. Me know some people claim say because him this and him that you can't rate him, but me rate him for that. Now, me listen to the debate and Donald Trump sound like him nonsense. But then again, I saw him sound all the while. When we just think now, when you add the element of vengeance and revenge and when I come in for the second term, I feel it is a danger to the wider world if you put him back in the White House. And we almost understand why people hate him so. We listen to the debate now. And me hear them say, as we said, the narrative was that Kamala wiped the floor with him. Me don't agree with that still. Me think they went toe-to-toe. And I don't know if people were forming that opinion based upon the unorthodoxies of Donald Trump. I wonder which cave they would live in. Because I see Donald Trump do nothing different or say nothing different in another debate here than what he said in a previous debate. And what he said, I'm rallying them. And what he said in a TV interviews and them something. Donald Trump will be Donald Trump. It is that unorthodox Donald Trump that got him to the White House. So someone not going like them in this proper politician. That never happen. That will never happen. If I had some people that look for another debate. So you know, Kamala Harris is a much more sophisticated and much more intelligent woman. And admittedly, I think she did a better job of avoiding the issues and the criticism that been coming her way and when Donald Trump tried to throw at her in a debate. Or even the unpopular things that she had to answer to by the people who are conducting the questioning. She was brilliant in evading those issues. The first question when them asked at the debate, Kamala Harris to answer the question, and she talked for about 5 minutes. She don't answer the question, none at all. I mean, I said, oh, what another debate people have been talking about? Now, as you went along further in the debate, now, this is when she started the strategy now, another smart strategy, where she start draw out Donald Trump, and that we call it in a Jamaican parlance. She start drop some little word on Donald Trump, because she know him thin skin and can't control him emotion, so she does drop some little thing. But she do that regular, and she did that expertly. So in terms of strategy, and kind of shifting the focus from herself and dodging the salient question them, and just speaking in broad general terms and platitudinous presentations, she was better than Donald Trump. What that was expected. Now, as to whether or not this is considered a decimation, I don't mind that something. But let me put it this way. I don't think one single individual who did not go vote for Donald Trump before the debate change their mind from vote for Donald Trump after the debate. I don't think one single solitary individual who was going to vote for Kamala Harris change their mind and say they may vote for Kamala Harris after the debate. Me not think it rock the needle. Me and them talk about some uncommitted. Them uncommitted, the original. Them know who them a vote for. See, them know exactly who them a vote for. Some of them don't want telling who them a vote for. So them a tell us them uncommitted. Now, so basically, me not think what happened in the debate here was decisive enough to affect how the people them a vote in November. I don't think Donald Trump should have gone back to the White House. That was me personally. Me like him for the entertainment, you know. Me the man entertaining like, wow. And me think when him come out of politics and him go back to a conventional Republican Party, the politics are boring. Me don't think them can find another personality like Donald Trump. I don't think they want to find another personality like Donald Trump. Me don't think him good for the White House. But can I tell you? I think the feminist agenda is already dominating our lives. And I think we run further danger when we reinforce the feminist agenda by putting a woman in the job and the leader of the free world. You see, if you're a man like me who consider myself an alpha male, the way that all men have been redefined in the society, I am not personally comfortable with it. Me not buy this thing about no gender neutrality and gender fluidity and me not buy that something there. And me know say the liberal agenda had a kind of something that them specialize in. And a liberal left leader who is a woman becoming a leader of the free world, me think we are going to further erode the conventional way of life there to an extent. So me not willing to risk it in the world right now. Now we know the narrative, a part of the narrative in the world, you know. When they say them kind of something, you know, them say you're misogynist and you're sexist. So there can be no rational reason, you know, for criticize a woman in the world, you know. This is a part of what we are talking about, you know. There's been no rational reason for criticize a woman, you know, and not wanting a woman in a position, except you're a sexist and you're a misogynist, you know. So when you face with a choice between Kamala Harris and Donald Trump, two of them may think dangerous. And Kamala Harris, not because of the person Kamala Harris, because of the direction where the world are going. So it's not Kamala herself for the danger, you know. It's the empowerment where she are going to give to the emasculation of men. I don't tell me say it now. Let me give you a perfect example. I don't ever tell this story on this channel already, but me are going to tell it again. One day, I'm in the pond, social media. What me do? On Facebook me there. A chat. Me no remember what me da chat about. Some one of them social issues. And a lady come in on the chat. And she start. And she post up something, say. She post a long time, you know. She post up something about toxic masculinity. Now at the time, me never really aware or fully okay with what the term toxic masculinity mean. I mean the word them pretty straightforward. So you could have think, say, well then they mean masculinity that is toxic. But me just ask the lady, say, what do you mean by toxic masculinity? And she explained. And when she explained to me, I said, hold on. But there's no difference between what you call toxic masculinity and just masculinity in and of itself. And the woman's retort was that masculinity in and of itself is toxic. From that day there, me not support that feminist agenda there. We don't support it. When we see the space where it come from. Because that lady was one of the warriors of them, you know, something, you know. Eventually, you know, they come. I never spoke to her again. We never encounter her again. But that exchange was an honest exchange between me and her and some other people on the chat. And when she tell me, say, it's too late now, it's far gone down the road now, we're taking control and all of those things that men did to women in previous generations is revenged. A sudden woman attacked to me, you know, people. And I said, Papa Jesus. I was serious something that woman you're talking about. And then after me had a conversation with the woman, I started noticing some things in the world. I see some things start happening in the world. Because you know, you go along and you not pray them something there. And I said, well, that's something that is real, you know. So from this, so people, as a man, we believe a man supposed to be a man in the traditional sense, when we come to know it culturally. And we're not talking about to exploit and abuse nobody, you know. It's just a man being a man. Yeah? And from that day, they decided to know that agenda is dangerous. But Donald Trump, probably more dangerous. So if it means he didn't have a vote, I don't have a vote, you know. Me don't know how I'm going to deal with the election. But I probably call in sick for the election. Because I don't like none of them candidates. Me personally don't like none of them candidates. Probably I'm going to go back for Sleepy Joe. All me call Sleepy Joe say I'm asleep on the job. I'm going to probably vote for Sleepy Joe. Anyway, the maverick that, you know. Me a step now. Madman in a clean clothes.